Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
We celebrate the 33rd Sunday of Ordinary Time. And we hear from the readings that each one of us has been given talents, gifts, spiritual blessings by God. And the call is to use those talents, to use those gifts to praise the Lord, to serve the Lord, and to serve our neighbor. As we reflect on these readings, we become aware of our shortcomings, the times that we have not used our talents, the times that we have not served God, the times that we have not served our neighbor. And now we turn to God and ask Him for the grace of healing and reconciliation. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Peace to God's people on earth.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth.
Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, the Holy One, you
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of Proverbs. Who can find a good wife? She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax, and works with willing hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hands to the poor, and reaches out her hands to the needy. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her words praise her in the gates. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Our response is, blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Blessed are those who fear the Lord and walk in his ways. By the labor of your hands you shall eat. You will be blessed and prosper. Blessed are all who fear the Lord. Your wife like a fruitful vine in the heart of your house. Your children like shoots of the olive around your table. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Indeed, thus shall be blessed the man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from Zion. May you see Jerusalem prosper all the days of your life. Blessed are those who fear the Lord. Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. As to the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need to have anything written to you, for you yourselves know well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. When people say, there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them, as labor pains come upon a woman with child, and there will be no escape. But you are not in darkness, brethren, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all sons of light and sons of the day. We are not of the night, nor of darkness. So then let us not sleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Abide in me, and I in you, says the Lord. He who abides in me bears much fruit. Alleluia, alleluia.
You have been faithful over a little. Enter into the joy of your master.
The Lord is with you. Listen now to a reading from the Holy Gospel according to the tradition of Matthew. At that time, Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called his servants and entrusted to them his property. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. He who had received the 5 talents went at once and traded with them, and he made 5 talents more. So also he who had the 2 talents made 2 talents more. But he who had received the 1 talent went and dug in the ground and hid his master's money. Now, after a long time, the master of those servants came and settled accounts with them. And he who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 talents more, saying, "Master, you delivered to me 5 talents. Here I have made 5 talents more." His master said to him, "Well done, a good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over little things. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master." And he who also had the 2 talents came forward, saying, "Master, you delivered to me 2 talents. Here I have made 2 talents more." His master said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over little things. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master." He also who had received the 1 talent came forward saying, "Master, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you did not winnow. So I was afraid. I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours." But his master answered, "You wicked and slothful servant, you knew that I reap where I have not sowed, and gather where I have not scattered. Then you ought to have invested my money with the bankers, and at my coming I should have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to him who has the 10 talents. For to everyone who has will more be given, and he will have abundance. But from him who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And cast the worthless servant into the outer darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
At Harare, I know tomorrow our suppers in the 8 houses where we live, one of the conversations that we enjoy will be the last sentence from the Gospel. No, sorry. The second last sentence in the Gospel. "He who has more, more shall be given. He who has nothing, even what they don't have, shall be taken away from them." So the guys, the little philosophical minds will be saying, if you don't have, what can be taken from you? And that can be very exciting for people who are studying philosophy. I don't aspire to be a philosopher, therefore I'm not going to concentrate on that sentence. I want to concentrate on the union of the first reading and the Gospel, talking about talents, gifts that we've received from God. For those who may remember the beginning of the letter to the Ephesians, it goes like this. Blessed be the Lord God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, for he has granted us all the spiritual blessings from the heavenly places. We have been given all the spiritual blessings when it comes to R and L coming next to each other. I always struggle because in Buja, which is my mother language, we don't have an R, we have an L. So all the spiritual blessings from the heavenly places we have been given. The demand is for us to acknowledge that we have been given all the spiritual blessings in heavenly places. We have been given a lot. Who unpack that? The first reading pictures wisdom like a good wife who is very beautiful, God-fearing, patient, virtuous. And it says it takes a virtuous person to notice or discover a virtuous wife. It takes someone who yearns, who desires to be wise, to notice wisdom. If you don't desire wisdom, you will not notice wisdom. If you don't yearn to be wise, you won't even see the wise among you. It takes a virtuous, or one who desires to be virtuous, to see a virtuous person. Haven't we heard in life that there are so many people who are gifted with very good spouses, but they don't see it? Or very good children, but they don't see it. Or even more interesting, very good, caring, loving parents, but they don't see it. Because we don't have the virtuous eye. We don't have the desire to be virtuous. It takes a good person to see a virtuous person. The wife, wisdom, the woman portrayed in the first reading, is not only God-fearing, but is loving to the neighbor. Is loving to the neighbor, who stretches out her arm to the poor and the needy, who is sensitive to the needs of the neighbor, to the needs of other people, who does not survive by personal interest, but looking at the common good, looking at the greater glory of God. And in this way, the little that she had, or the little that she has, is multiplied because of giving others. I've watched a number of short videos on YouTube where some of these motivational speakers portray someone who was struggling in life. And the person is helped by another person who later on struggles in life. And the person who the first person helped comes to the rescue of the second person, the first person. So there is a young man in America, black American, who was struggling, couldn't go to school. And there's a white lady who was affluent that time. So she helped this young guy who was living in the streets to go to school. So the guy worked so hard, he went to school, he became a medical doctor. And one day, this white woman lost almost everything she had. She lost her husband, she lost her job, and she was in medical need. But she didn't have money to meet the medical bills. And in came the young man who is now a doctor. Recognized the woman and treated her for free. And she only recognized him when she was discharged from hospital. And he said, "Why are you helping me?" And he said, "You helped me 20 years ago when I was living in the streets. And he taught me one thing. Help 3 more people in life, and he transformed the world. A single talent can transform the world if it is multiplied. The wise woman stretches out her hand to the poor, and she stretches out her arm to the needy. Virtue challenges us or demands of us to stretch out our arms to the poor and the needy. And you notice the first reading actually says, charm is deceitful and beauty is vain. The description of wisdom as a good wife is not based on physical appearance. It's not based on attractiveness. It's based on virtue, on the heart. How much is the heart willing and ready to share with those who need our assistance? I guess the question to ask for us is, asking ourselves individually, what have I been given by God? What talent or talents have I received from God? And how do I use them? Are you like the one who got 5 talents and invested them and got 5 more talents? Or the other one who was given 2 talents and he multiplied them and he got 2 more talents? And remember the statement that is almost a disclaimer in the gospel. Each one was given according to their ability. We are not given the same talents. Each one is given talents according to their ability. God does not give us something that is beyond our ability. He gives us something within our own ability. What we are able to do, what you are able to multiply is what is given to you. So you have only yourself to blame when you dig down a hole and put the talents that were given by God and hide them and wait for God to come and say, I know, you reap where you don't sow. So here are your talents. Nelson Mandela, once addressing an audience in America, he said, I don't know if there was a question that was asked, but I just watched this clip. He said, I am a simple human being. I am not a saint. I have great weaknesses. I am a sinner. You can only call me a saint if by the word saint you mean a person who is a sinner but keeps trying to do good to others and society. You can only call me a saint if by that you mean a person who is a sinner but keeps trying to do good to others and to society. I find that very applicable to the reflections we have today. We are all sinners. We all have weaknesses. And we live in a sinful world. But we are called to try every day to do good to others and to society. For those who may know a bit about the Jesuits, they have come to define themselves as a Jesuit is a sinner yet called to be holy by the Lord. A sinner yet called to be holy by the Lord. And I think that applies to every Christian, every person of goodwill. We are all sinners, yet called to be holy. We are all sinners, yet called to be good. We have been given talents to invest and multiply for the greater glory of God and for the common good of society. We need to take time to reflect on what talents we have and how are we multiplying them. How are we investing so so that we get more talents and spread them around. And as I say this, I know we are living in a very individualistic, very selfish world where giving people is almost becoming a taboo. Young men, they see models like the one who was buried, is it yesterday or today? Who was buried yesterday, the so-called Ginimbi. Every time and then, some of us, we didn't know him until we started hearing a lot about his death, and then we said, who is he? And we see videos of him every time showing money, using money and so forth. And you know, there's another pastor who puts up billboards, very big boards, big billboards, and he puts his name there and only a sign. And they say, oh, this money could be used to help other people. But because we are living in an individualistic world, they are satisfied with showing off what they have. They are satisfied with showing off their talents that the Lord has given them. They are not thinking of multiplying the talents, investing in helping others, investing in the glory of God. They are investing in personal glory. And as you know, personal glory does not last forever. And now the young man, genius, is no more. Peace upon his soul. But all the wealth that he was accumulating, he left that. I wish material things could be transformed into spiritual things so that when we die, we go with our material things, with our wealth, into the spiritual world. But alas, all the material things remain here. And someone else is going to enjoy them. I hope those who are going to enjoy the material things left by the young man will be more responsible. The call is to use the talents that we receive from God. It is unspiritual. It is unspiritual to pride ourselves about the talent that we receive from God. To hate others who don't have on the basis of what we have. To show off to others that we have and they don't have. It is spiritual and it is virtuous to know what you have and to share with others. It is godliness and an expression of faith to know what we got from God and to yearn to stretch out our arms to the poor, to the needy. The example presented to us by the two faithful servants who are given more because of generosity should be the challenge of our day, should be the challenge of our lives every day, should be the challenge of our relationships. How much are you sensitive to the needs of the person who lives next to you? How much value are you giving to the lives of other people? How much are you ready to invest what you have in order to help others? The unprofitable servant who hid the talent is going to be thrown away in darkness. And he represents those of us who hear the word of God every day, every Sunday, and we remain unmoved, unchanged. The unprofitable servant are those of us who don't put effort to cooperate with the grace of God in us, to invest in the talents we have been given by God. And let us pray today, this week, that we may be aware of the talents that we got from God and we may use them for the greater glory of God and for the common good of society.
Let us now stand to profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of me, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was the Son of God, and became man. For our sake he was crucified by the Holy Spirit. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scripture. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Most High, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one of the sins of the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And now let us take a moment to call to mind all the people, all the situations that we want to pray for, the graces we want to ask God. Continue to pray for peace in our families, peace especially to those who have tension and conflict in their families. We pray for peace to those who are going through stress, frustration, or depression in their lives. We pray for peace and comfort to those who are living in the pain of poverty. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
we pray that we may be aware of the gifts that have been granted us by God, the talents we have, and we pray for a growing desire to multiply these talents and invest them for the greater glory of God, for the common good of society, for the good of others. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious in us.
Make all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
us pray that our sacrifice may be pleasing and acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift your heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and
just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his Paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
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 holy.
Heaven and earth
are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks. He said the blessing, and he gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all men, women, and children, all generations across nations, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her blessed spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of the whole world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and all those who support his vision and the work he's doing to restore the image of the church in the world. Robert Ndrove, our Archbishop, and the Order of Bishops, and all the clergy, and all those who minister to you and to your people in various ways. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you this morning. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our sick brothers, sisters, parents, grandparents, friends and companions and neighbors, we pray for healing and comfort. And to our departed brothers, sisters, friends, parents and grandparents and neighbors, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ taught us to call God our Father, the Father of the whole creation. Let us now turn to him and address all our needs to him as we pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
your kingdom come,
your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
And now, in the depth of our hearts, let us pray for peace. Let's pray for peace to all those who are living in tension, conflict, distress, or depression. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity. In accordance with your will, you will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Amen.
At least a smile at each other, wherever we are, we do. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
And behold, my brothers, my sisters, the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are we, and all those invited to his banquet. Lord,
I am not ready to touch the entire man. I do not say a word, and my soul shall be healed.
May God help Christ bring us to life.
given to me, and his giving is as gentle as silence. Every day,
I got an insight or inspiration just now that under normal circumstances outside COVID lockdown, we all come physically before the altar, some to receive the body of Christ and others to receive a blessing. And normally young people would come like this and ask for a blessing. I would like to ask all those who have not received the body of Christ to stand wherever they are. And we ask for God's blessing, special blessing for them, including those who are around. And let us pray. Lord Jesus, when you come from us, we enjoy communion with you, communion with each other. We enjoy listening to your word. We enjoy receiving you through your word. We enjoy receiving you through the companionship and the communion that we enjoy with others. We also enjoy receiving you through the mystery of consecration. You are united with us in the depths of our hearts. Bless all these, your children, your brothers and sisters. We have not been privileged to receive your body today, but they've received your word and they've received you in the depths of their hearts. Bless them with the grace of experiencing your presence in their lives, the grace of experiencing your peace and your love in their lives. May they pass on this grace. May they pass on the peace and the love and your presence to others. We make this prayer through you, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Thank you. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has ended. Let us go in the peace and the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you very much and have a blessed week.
Amen.